mentioned how you're working with all promoters at this point with these shows. Yeah. There's been indication from actually Dana White that he wants to go ahead and enter into boxing. What do you make of that? And how do you see the UFC coming in and doing the whole boxing thing? How do you see that playing out if it does in fact happen? Because he stated in multiple interviews that he is very interested in promoting boxing shows now.
Well, you know, Dana has come up with a tremendous structure at the UFC. I mean, the success that that company has had is, I wouldn't say it's unprecedented, but he's really left his stamp on the, you know, combat sports. So if he can do what he did with the UFC and with MMA and transition that into the sport of boxing, you know, I think he has a good chance of being successful. You know, it just, boxing definitely is a completely different sport than mixed martial arts. I mean, you know, UFC did a pretty good job of creating kind of a monopoly where, you know, they could create their own ratings, they can create their own mandatories, their own titles, and so they could force, unlike in boxing, they could actually force their fighters or dictate to their fighters who was going to fight each other, and that's why you see a lot of exciting fights in the UFC. In boxing, there's, you know, many different sanctioning bodies, a lot of different promoters that won't work with each other, TV networks that won't work with each other, so now you got, it's a lot more fractured. And as a lot of people have experienced, a lot of people like to go into the sport of boxing, but then they get frustrated because there is a lot of politics, and you know, it's hard to put on the best shows unless you're working with a lot of other promoters. So you know, we'll have to see what direction he goes into. I think maybe they got bit by the boxing bug with the McGregor and Mayweather fight. They saw, you know, how big a successful boxing pay-per-view can be, both on the ticketing and the international side and on the pay-per-view side. So, but, you know, like I said, Dana's had a lot of success in mixed martial arts, and we'll see what he wants to do if he does make the also go into boxing.
I know the press conferences will be a lot more interesting. Knowing him, he's going to be telling people, that's a stupid question, and you're going to be hearing that left and right if that does happen.
Dana brings his own brand of entertainment to the media event. So, yeah, sure, there would be, you know, he would bring his own excitement to the boxing.
Now, I know everybody watching this is, like, probably thinking at this point, oh, go ahead.
Plus, Dana's a big Triple G fan. In fact, I've seen, you know, where he said that he only watches boxing when Triple G fights. So we got to respect him for that. He's really been supportive of Triple G and the fights that Gennady's had. And, you know, I think he recognizes that Gennady is one of those rare guys that's willing to fight anyone and wants to put on exciting fights. And that's why, you know, we've had the success that we've had with Gennady. And I think Dana for sure recognizes that and respects what Gennady's accomplished inside the ring and what we've accomplished with him outside the ring.
Did you see him that night? Because I know he was there.
I saw him at the when we actually sat next to him when Canelo fought Chavez. We were sitting with Gennady and Abel, and he was sitting just one row behind us. So we saw him that night. I didn't see him at the at our fight because there were so many things going on. You know, when Triple G fought Canelo, but we saw him at the Chavez fight.
Because I was curious to see how he scored it. If you had a chance to talk to him about it, see how he scored the fight.
I don't know how he scored it, but I'd be willing to bet that Dana had Triple G winning that fight, like 80%, 90% of the rest of the people.